Good morning, guys. And you've got a very sleepy one coin here for the opposite reason of you guys. As I always say, you guys are just getting up for the day. I am preparing for bed. So I'm almost ready for bed, but we're going to have 2 hours of fun here first, guys. Thank you very, very, very much for joining us. This morning we're going to play some Mega Man 10. And then as a bonus for the very, very first time on One Coin Only, we are going to be doing a game called The Stanley Parable, which is an awesome walking simulator, a great narrative experience. And I thought I might show you guys that as a bonus game today. So that's what we got for the next couple of hours. And we are live on both Facebook and YouTube. We've got Punisher James and Rain over on YouTube. I will do a VR game one day when I own VR, Rain. And then over on the Facebook, we got Cap, we got Lamont, and we got Randall there, we got Roman, Joseph, Kat, Dave, Brian, Luther, Jacob, Nick, Brett, and James. Really appreciate you guys. Don't forget to get on that like and share train. With that being said, we're going to get started. We're going to go to the main screen. We're going to play some very cruisy Mega Man 10. I would say, especially with the settings that I use, this is probably the easiest Mega Man game you're going to play. Definitely a great starting point. Very, very casual. Breakfast at Ricky D's. Oh, I'd love some food right now. I need to stop eating, man. I've been eating way too much lately. It's a normal thing. What was I going to say? Yeah, just because of like... Hey, D-Wayne, good to see you. Great stream before, by the way, man. I was watching most of it in the background. Just being stuck in the house all the time with this mice. No, yeah, man, it was a pretty tough Nintendo stream yesterday, but I think most people were entertained by it, so thank you for watching. I definitely stepped out of my comfort zone with last night's stream, that's for sure. Hitmonkey says, forget that Mega Man 10 isn't as good as Mega Man X. Well, thank you for your opinion, Hitmonkey, but if I wanted your fucking opinion, guess what? I would have fucking asked you for it. Nah, good to see you, man. Thank you for coming in. I love it when I come on with a game, and then people are like, it's not as good as this game, and I'm like thinking, you son of a bitch, seriously. This is the game we're playing, and that is that. If you don't like it, too freaking bad. Oh my goodness. Nothing wrong with some pie, man. I like me some pumpkin pie. Hey, go on, Jen. It's good to see you. Thank you for coming in. So the Hitmonkey says, well, I had to throw some shade. No, you didn't. You didn't. You could have just come in and been nice, bruh. But no, gotta throw some bullshit. You don't have to throw no shade. Well, what are you justifying that on? Oh my goodness. Hey, how you going, Pi Nation? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Oh boy. I love Mega Man 10. It's just a fun, casual Mega Man game. I am going to be learning how to play Mega Man 8 because I haven't streamed Mega Man 8 yet. That's coming. Quarantine pounds. I think we all have them. Yeah, I lose a couple pounds and then I'll eat a whole cheesecake and go up another couple pounds again. Like, I ate a whole freaking cheesecake yesterday amongst other things. Oh my goodness. What's everyone getting up to today? Anyway, as I said, once again, big thank you for coming in. As much as I love Mega Man 10, I am really looking forward to finally showing you Stanley Parable today. And I'm kind of glad that D-Wayne came in as well, because D-Wayne, I've been meaning to show you Stanley Parable for a very long time. So even if you're busy to hang around, you can check out the replay for yourself, see if it's your cup of tea. I remember we were talking about that. This isn't Mega... What time is it, Jesse? Sorry, Jesse. It's currently 11 p.m. where I'm at. No. Well, that's a thing. Everyone comes on One Coin, acts all obnoxious. And I'm like, motherfucker, I'm the only one that's allowed to act obnoxious on my own channel. Thank you very much. You will come in, you'll watch my content, and you will love it. Only I'm allowed to be obnoxious. Only messing. Hey, go on, Robert. Good to see you. Oh, Jared, it's okay. They're there to be eaten, my friend. They're there to be eaten. I just hope you guys like another season of Be to Eat It. Hey, go on, Apes. Good to see you, girl. Thank you for coming in. And we got Aaron in here. Appreciate you guys very much. Let me just focus on this sumbish quickly. There we go, we're gonna go up that sumbish. And then Hit Monkey says Ricky's wound up tight at the beginning of the stream. No, I'm actually... I think I just had a ping spike on YouTube. Let me know if everything's okay. So some... yeah. You're good and don't troll. Yes, we don't like trolls here at One Coin. They get the back end. Are you waiting for the clapping song again? Yes, we made an interesting song on One Coin last night about the clap, didn't we? Okay, anyway, back out here. D-Wayne says, what's happening today? Oh, I was just saying I'd love you to see the Stanley Parable, because I know you're interested in it. But I'm doing Beat It or Eat It. I'm going to show you what we're doing for Beat It or Eat It quickly. I'll give you guys a sneak peek. If we lose Beat It or Eat It today, we have to eat these. The hottest chips on the planet. They're called the hottest corn chips. Are you game? They're fused with Ghost, Scorpion, and Carolina Reaper peppers. And if you look at the disclaimer on the back, it says, do not eat on an empty stomach. Do not eat if you have an allergy. Do not eat if you're sensitive to spicy foods. Do not eat if you have a cardiac condition. Do not eat if you have gastrointestinal problems. Okay, that might count me out, but YOLO. Don't eat if you're breastfeeding. I'm pretty sure if I breastfed, I'd probably be sent to jail. And if you have any other medical conditions. So there's a big disclaimer on the box. It's no fucking around with these corn chips. Easy peasy. Yeah, man, you know me with hot food. I'll be fine. So, nah, we'll be all good, mate. Oh, absolutely, D-Wayne. I mean, I hope you're... I'll let you know behind the scenes, brother. I'll let you know off the stream. Sorry, bro, I wasn't sure what you were talking about. Yeah, absolutely, I'll tell you when we're done. Oh, gosh. Yeah, apparently these chips... it doesn't have the Scoville units on the box, but apparently they're about 1.5 million. I call bullshit. I don't think they're quite that hot, but we're going to find out, aren't we? Oh, my goodness. Let's just get this sucker. Ah, damn you. Hello there, Governor. Good to see you, Daniel. Thank you for coming in. Let me just beat this boss. You got some dip to go with those, you missus. I think they've got enough flavor. I don't think they're going to require no dip. Hey, go on, Nick Force. Good to see you. Rick, don't talk about that game. What game? Is that if you're breastfeeding or if you're being breastfed? There you go, Hit Monkey asking questions. Oh, shit, bro. I hope I don't have heart condition. I don't know. Oh, we go Scoville. Or whatever they call it. Yeah, Scottsville. You love how they came up? Yeah, man, Capcom know how to deliver a great soundtrack. There is a theme in this Mega Man game that I really like. And I'll let you know what it is when we get up to it. You spent the last couple days putting up an 18-foot pool for the kids. Well, Nick, you're a good sport, my friend. How's that going? A little above-ground pool and stuff. How often do you have to treat those things? Do you have to put chlorine in it, like, every day? And, all right, there we go. We got ourselves some Thunderwall, guys. Boom! Yeah, the Thunderwall! What the fuck up, mate? The peppers and the chips are made with my shibuya. Yeah. Alright, what are we gonna do now? We're gonna do Pump Man. There we go. Luther, no jokes about pumping! There we go. I'm trying to censor Luther before he gets started today. We have no pump jokes today, thank you very much. We're gonna go back off on ya. There we go. Now remind me to go to the shop after this is all done. Fusion dance. Add chlorine when the pH is off. So how do you measure it? Do you have like a little gauge or something, do ya? Hit Monkey says, you wonder if Capcom is gonna push out some more Onimusha love. I think that's part of the reason it got re-released on modern consoles, probably to test the water and see if there was a market for it. I think I think they might be at least thinking about it. Otherwise, they wouldn't have re-released it if they didn't think it was marketable. Something, you know. I want to do Warlords for you guys one day. I've been wanting to practice Onimusha for a long time. It's homework. Luther cannot be sent. Would you, are you, do you guys like Onimusha, or do you think it's too, like, niche? Pretty good. Join the stream and eating some potato pies. Some pie. Go up. How do we get up there like this? Alright, moving on up. Oh, my little, okay, pea shooter back here. Alright, we got this. Open your little helmet, dickhead. Alright, we got him. You just put a gallon of chlorine in a day, and if it turns to coast colours, it's too strong. If it slightly burns a kid's skin, wait another half hour. Yeah, I hear it's pretty hectic. You like those games where you think they're very niche, yeah. Because Onimusha I've got on PS4, but I haven't learned how to play it yet. So Mel says you're not waking up for... Man, you don't need to be waking up, Mel, for Mega Man. You got this. As I said, a big thank you once again for joining us this morning, guys. I hope you're having a lovely start to the day. Hitmonkey says he's been playing some Shadow of the Tomb Raider. You dig it, huh? Maybe I'll have to try that one day. We've got Jeffrey in here. Jeffrey, I don't see you too much these days. Barkaroo! Jeffrey, thank you for coming in. There we go. We've got that little W. Jeffrey, everything is fine here. Thank you, my friend. I'm just trying to put in a decent stream for you guys before bed. My brain's hardly working right now. It's got me what's new. Ryan says, can we see you stream Final Fantasy X? Nope. I'm not doing Final Fantasy X anytime soon because I tried to stream that for you guys and it absolutely tanked the channel. So if you want to see these games, they need to be supported. It's as simple as that. I can't keep beating a dead horse. So if I don't, you know, unfortunately it's, unfortunately the entertainment industry is a view-orientated industry. And if I'm not getting the results on a certain game, then I can't keep going, so... Fuck, I hate this thing. Oh my gosh, like, really? Alright, let's try this side, hang on. Ah, son of a biscuit, like, really? I'm just trying to get out of here, man! Oh, there we go, here. Let's just bout fuckity-doodah, man. I just made up a new word, fuckity-doodah. Aussie word of the day, fackety-doodah. I haven't decided what the definition is yet, but okay. No, that's okay, Jeffrey. I know this man. Nick says he sent me stars. I'm so sorry, Nick. I'm gonna go back up. Sorry, bro. The chat's going a million miles an hour. Nick, thank you very much for the kind stars. This is going out to you, Nick, with 100 stars. Thank you, Nick. And Nick, they were also the first stars of the stream as well, so thank you very much, bud. I really, really appreciate that. I'm gonna, Oh, boy. Yeah, fackety-doodah. Making up new Aussie words here. Swinging in the breeze. The fairy likes that one, too. Man, that's the thing about being an Australian. You can make up a new phrase every day of the week and it'll stick. Us Australians are constantly rewriting the dictionary, mate. It's what we do. It's part of the charm, mate. Oh, the little T-bomb wall here, let's go. There we go, how you freaking like that one, you little sumbitch? Boom, how you fucking like that one? Oh, Aussie, mate. Got some of this Aussie stormy weather right here. Come get that prick. Yeah, we got him. We're gonna go back to the pea shooter now. Damn you. Like shitballs. Yeah, shitballs is a very Aussie phrase, isn't it? Oh, hang on. You use that in the US, don't you? I think you might have stolen it from us, though. How you going, Jado? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. We got Gareth in here. How you going today, brother? I hope you're doing really well. We got Gareth in here on YouTube. Thanks for coming in, man. Gareth's been about a part of OneCoin for probably about 1,000 days now. And Johnny just dropped a big 100 stars. Johnny, thank you for looking out. What are we going to give to Johnny? This one. Skanky, brutal, bottom feeding, trash bag, ho! What? No, Luther, and I'm afraid to ask you that story too, Johnny. Thank you again for the 100 stars. I'm afraid to ask. I'm not going to ask you that story until one point after dark, Luther. I'm sorry. You need to try the little nitro, the gummy bear. It's over 9 million on the Scoville scale. Well, sorry, bro, but let's work up to that point, shall we, Oliver? Jeez, man. Oliver wants me to kill myself. That's fine, whatever. Oh, gosh. Or a fuck ton. Yeah, that's Aussie phrase today. A fuck ton. It means lots and lots. So it'd be like, oh, look, old mate Bill went to the pub and he had to get a taxi home because he had a fuck ton of beers. That means he had a lot of beers. There you go, fuck ton. That's Aussie word of the day. I love it, Perry. There you go. We got it. How you going, Joshy? Good to see you. Hey, we got Carlos in here. Como estas, my friend? I hope you and the family are staying safe during this My Sharona epidemic, my friend. I hope you're doing okay. Oh my gosh, I'm just slipping all over the place here. Thank you for coming in, man. I haven't spoken to you in a bit. There we go, we got this. So Como says you need to shout me this gummy and send it to my post office box, but he's just kidding, Oliver. You can tell me where I can get one of these things, though, and I'll order it from the show. I'd love to do it on the show. If you can send me a link or something, I will definitely buy it for a future episode. If it kills me, well, you can pay my medical bills. Back over here. Bob drank a fuck ton of piss. Yeah, that's it. Now, can you imagine if, like, we went to the United States to someone that had never spoken to an Australian before, and they'll be like, Rick, why are you late to our dinner party? And we're like, because Bob drank a fuck ton of piss. Like, they wouldn't know what we were talking about. Oh my gosh, I'd probably get arrested in certain states, I don't know. Damn it, I'm really struggling with this, but we'll get there. There you go, I'm just trying to jump over it. Yeah, crap. Oh, these things are annoying. It's okay. Come on, you sun biscuit. Oh, how many times am I going to shoot you assholes? There we go, that's one. Get back down from ya. Come on, you asshat. Alright, we got him. No, it should be, I had a fat ton of beers and rooted the Sheilas. It should be Sheilas, not Spice Girls. Replace Spice Girls with Sheilas. And you're speaking Australian one, you're close. How you going, Andrew? Good morning to you. Thank you for coming in. Appreciate you, my brother. Thanks for hanging out. Oh, Struth, mate. How you going, Murphy as well? We've also got Murphy in here today. Thank you for coming in. As I said, guys, Mega Man action to start the day, and then after this, we are going to do some Stanley Parable for the first time. Something a little bit more obscure, but fun. Like, it's actually a really neat experience for 20 or 30 minutes. So, yeah, about a 2-hour stream today. If I don't keep fucking dying like a freaking dog. Oh my gosh. Let's try this again. Alright. Gotta be a bit more careful here, guys. He almost had it. You were pretty close, man. You should be proud. How are we going for lives? I need to go back to this one. 6. No, that's plenty. What else is happening with you guys? What are you getting up to for the day anyway? Anything new? Get a hot cup of coffee? I tell you what, if I have to eat these corn chips tomorrow, it'll probably be a good thing before the late night stream, because it'll like wake me up. And I need to stay awake because, my gosh, we got another big whatever Wednesday this week. Like, it's really, really big, actually. So, which is good for you guys. Gareth says, Facebook booted you from all my streams last night. I don't know what the hell is going on, man. Sorry to hear, dude. Going back over here. Let's see, so basically the Stanley game is a walking simulator. Now, what's really appealing about the Stanley Parable is each playthrough is only about 5-10 minutes long tops, and there's multiple branching paths, and there's a narrator. He's kind of like some British guy like David Attenborough. Not David Attenborough, but you know, someone real posh. And someone famous apparently narrates a game. And anyway, you're just basically telling different stories, walking different directions. It's really interesting. Like, you just have to experience it at least once. So Brandon says, and just chilling it and kicking. Well, there you go. Fuck, get off me, you little fucking sun thing. You sent me the link and it's Australian made. Thank you, Oliver. Hell yeah. Well, that'll be easy to order. I'll get one for next month. I've got some other chilly things to do, but we'll work up to it. I'm gonna use the water shield here. Let's go. You streaked at a dinner party once. You hate that it was so cold in the dining room. You would have had the worst case of shrinkage. And, yeah, that just reminds me of that episode of Seinfeld when George went for a swim. Oh, I love it. By the way, ladies, oh, actually, I'm not going to go into that until One Coin After Dark. Let's just say shrinkage is a real thing if you do get in the cold anyway. How you going, Dean? Thank you. Dean Douglas says, hello, hello, Omega Man is cool. Good to see you. We got 1993 WWE's Dean Douglas in the house. No, that's okay, Brian. You have a great start today. It's all good, my man. I hope you guys have, you gotta log your son to his Zoom school session. I hear this Zoom is pretty unreal, huh? Can we go back? I keep go back to the menu. What? Let me just do that. Yeah, I just gotta go to the shop and buy some things. Alright, hold up. Welcome back, Mega Man. You can use the screws you've collected to purchase items from the shop. So there we go, yes. Right, and then we're gonna go get a couple of these. Alright, cool. Alright, so we're gonna go to the next level. What are we gonna do now? Chill, man. Alright, cool. Give him the boot. Hey, we got Voxney in the house. Good to see you, Amber. Thank you so much for hanging out today. And Daniel, I did have a quick look through your list, and they're pretty neat, man. But, look, I really, really appreciate you going to the effort. But at the same time, Daniel, I'm nowhere near close to being able to organize a one-point-only video game. So this will be something, for in the future. But I tell you what, Daniel, I really do like your vision, though. So thank you for going to the effort. I appreciate it. But this is something we'll have to talk about at a much later date. So a big shout-out to Voxney Gaming. Guys, don't forget to please check out Voxney Gaming, Commodore 64, and, of course, Mr. Headlock Gaming as well, guys. Support those that support us, and also enjoy their awesome content. Otherwise, I'll fucking bash her, as we say in Australia. That's another Aussie phrase. Hey, if you don't shut up, I'll fucking bash her. What that means is, if you don't be quiet, I'll punch your head in. That's basically what that means in Australian. But you know what? You know, friends actually say that to each other in our country. We're really weird. Did you know there's a Mega Man for the Sega? Yeah, I grew up with it. I was very, very fortunate that it was released in Australia, Dean, like on a physical cartridge. So yeah, I grew up with that game. You wore your new OneCoin merch out this week, and there you go, spreading the name. Thank you, Voxney. Hey, Golanor, good to see you. Thank you for coming in. What'd I say about Commodore 60? Oh, that's another word, pash. Oh, I went to the pub and I got real junk and I pashed a couple Sheilas. That means you French kissed a couple girls. If an Australian says he pashed a Sheila, it means he French kissed a girl. So yeah. Pashing and pashing, yeah. Good old pash. We had a pash behind the dunnies and then we went off and had a root. Oh, hang on, that's terrible. I can't say that right now. I'm so sorry. Little Timmy's probably in the room. Forgive me. Oh my goodness. Lenore's all like, ew. There you go. Yeah, I'm just trying to teach everyone the Aussie phrases here. You know, it's a public service. Gotta give back to the community, you see. Oh boy. I think we're almost out of here. Man, I love this game. It's just so cruisy compared to other Mega Mans. Especially on the settings I have it on. I don't have to worry about annoying pitfalls. So Commodore 64 Brannigan on Facebook, sexiest... I thought it said the sexist. No, because I'd be the most sexist streamer. But yes, you are the sexiest streamer. Congratulations. You're the sexiest and I'm the sexist. So Dean says you can only imagine how the women talk over here. Oh gosh. Man, I tell you what, this is a problem with Aussie women. This is the problem. This is the problem with Aussie women. You could see this beautiful girl, especially out in the Gold Coast, that's absolutely like absolute 10. She's absolutely gorgeous. And then she'll be start speaking, she'll be like, fuck, cunt, fuck, fuckity cunt, cunt, fuck. And it's just like, oh my gosh. Okay, stay away from me. That's kind of what a lot of Aussie women are like, honestly. sorry for the C-bomb. I had to get my point across, but that's what they do. Anyway. Yeah, that's literally what they do. If you don't believe me, ask Perry. if you don't believe me, ask Perry. I'm not lying. That's what they're like on the Gold Coast in particular. They're really sexy until they start talking. The Bogan Mole Syndrome. Thank you, Perry. See, he knows what's up. Mark, good morning. Thank you for coming in. I'm sorry, April. I wasn't saying you. April's got a little bit more class. It's all good. I wasn't talking about April. How you going, Mark? It's good to see you, Mark. Thank you again for the 100 stars. Going out to you, brother. Appreciate you. Mike says you leave for 5 minutes and you come back there. Man, I just got no filter. It's going to get me in trouble one day. And then Jimmy Bob says that's just most Queenslanders in your experience. Oh, gosh. We got Aaron in here as well. Aaron, thank you for the big 100 stars as well. I really appreciate that. Going out to you.
I'm warning you, TC.
Thank you, Aaron.
Stay out of trouble.
If it wasn't for trouble, you'd be out of a job.
You're a riot, Tomcat.
Anyway. No, okay, Daniel. It's all good, man. I appreciate your enthusiasm, though. You're great ideas, man, my friend. Oh gosh, you got a new weapon, a chill spike. Alright, and we also got the rush jet. Well, that's alright. I like to rush around on a jet. Awesome sauce. Alright, we're gonna pick the next stage. So we got the chill spike, so I think we're gonna go against Nitro Man now. Patrick also with 100 stars. One coin, one Ricky, one Mega Man, all as good as in this stream. I think so too, my friend. We're off to a great start today, brother. Thank you, Patrick. You're absolutely awesome, and a very good morning to you, my friend. Oh, we got little cutscenes here, but I'm not gonna... There we go. Basically, what we need to do is find a cure for the Roboenza. That's what we're doing now. And apparently, you know, Dr. Wily's pretending to be our friend, and you're gonna find out it's all a ruse. Okay. I don't really care about the talky-talky bits. So Jared says in Perth, it's a whole new level. As I said, I'm not, you know, not all Aussie girls are like that, but it's quite common, especially, like, with the younger... Look, April, look where I'm from. I live in Logan. A lot of guys and girls talk like that. Am I correct, April? Am I correct? Let's just call a spade here. Like, look, the first thing I think of when I... Look, think of Callum Vale. Just think of Callum Vale, and then you tell me if I'm right or wrong. You want some banana... Hey, banana waffles are great. There we go, I don't need really use that right now. Hey, good morning, Kid Jackson. Good to see you. It's a plan till Mega Man 11. I love Mega Man 11. I played Mega Man 11 much too much, but that's just because it's one of my favorite Mega Man games, if not my favorite now. Passion, you assume, is shorthand for passionate. I guess Hitmonkey. I don't know, us Aussies make crazy words up. And April's like, ooh, Callum Bale. Look at you playing the game you plan to request for whatever Wednesday. Well, there you go. I mean, you don't need to request a game now, Brandon. Good deed done. Quick, Ricky, take my shovel. Keep... Bro, if there's anyone that knows how to dig holes in his life, that's certainly one coin. You only went to... Oh, see, look at April making me feel all special. Thank you, girl. What's a Stanley Parable? Well, you're going to find out. It's a neat little niche game, but it's a really good one. Stanley Parable is a game everyone needs to experience at least once. Jared says, Logan's pretty bogan in Queensland, but you still got nothing on Ipswich. Yeah, my roommate's from Ipswich. And I always tell him, and he's a good sport, but I always tell him the best thing about going to Ipswich is leaving Ipswich. It's true. April, you tell me that's not true. See, I'm always using April as my backup. Oh, goodness. Stanley Parable can definitely be a little bit of a mind fuck, just depending on the options that you pick, sure. It definitely has a potential. There we go, we got this. So Rick, on Beater Eater, how hard is it to add subtract time on the timer? No, I can work around it, but I don't want to add those to the wheel yet. I don't think we need to. I just feel like sometimes with things, less is more, and I don't want to add too many gimmicky things. Like, if I come up with a really good idea, I'll add it to the wheel, but I don't want to do a gimmick just for the sake of doing a gimmick. Do I remember... Oh, Pauline Hanson, please explain! Yes, the Red... Captain Red herself. Bro, I think she made a deal with the devil, because she looks exactly the same now as she did back in 1995, mate. She doesn't look any different in, Yeah, she doesn't look any different. Like, I don't know how old she was back then, and I don't know how old she is now. But she don't look no different. Ah, Quinana. Well, it sounds like a nice name, at least. The only positive thing about your town is the Southern Freeway. It's named after your city, so Quinana. But, I mean, that sounds just a nice name, at least. Ipswich sounds as bad as what it is. So Kid Jackson says, what was for dinner? I had a couple meat pies. I had two meat pies, put some chili sauce on them. There you go, done. I had a late lunch, so I just had a light dinner, just two little pies. They invented the toothbrush in Ipswich. Anywhere else would be called the teeth brush. Dun dun. How you going, Chris? Nice to see you again. Thank you for coming in. Oh my gosh, I couldn't live in Ipswich. I actually had to DJ a few weekends in Ipswich. They used to have a pub there called Cocktails, and then they changed the name of it to something else, but I used to DJ in Ipswich. And oh my gosh, just spending a small amount of time there, you saw some crazy shit in that main strip, bro. Everything from brawls to like lovemaking and everything in the public space, it was just... It's a whole different universe in Ipswich. they can't... I'm gonna leave that one alone, Luke, because I'll get in trouble. And how are you going, Mr. Drew? Thank you for coming in. We also got Enrique in here. Ryan said he had a free dinner, so what'd you have for dinner, Ryan? You live in the suburb of Funky Cold Medina, you kid you not, you hate that bloody song. What do you mean the suburb of Funky Cold Medina? I did not realise, hang on, that wasn't filmed in Aussie, was it? Hang on, I don't get it. I remember the song Funky Cold Medina, Tony Locke. And he also did that song, Wild Thing. Anyway, but yeah, Funky Cold Medina. Man, that's a blast from the past. Man, I loved all that party hip-hop back in the day, man. Like, that harmless stuff. Like, do you remember Young MC, Busta Move and all that? Like, that really clean sort of, like, rap. I loved it. But it didn't take itself too seriously. Oh, no, I gotcha. I was gonna be like, yeah, what are you on about? Okay, I see. Joey says Ipswich sounds fair dinkum. Nah, it really isn't. It really isn't, mate. Right, going back over here. Back over this side. I'm hoping we don't... Oh, crap, that was close. All right, come on, Rick. Patience, mate, patience. Oh, apple shitballs. Oh, no! Fuckity, that was lucky, dude. There you go, that's what happens. Get your little flying bish over there. So, Catherine says, who could pick you up in a sports car and take you to get pizza? Well, I will say this to you, Catherine. You've got bloody arms and legs. Get your own pizza. Oh, look at this. Catherine wiggling her finger trying to get the boys to go get a pizza. Get your own pizza, chick. You got arms and legs. You're 8 or 9 when Funky told... What, when Funky Cold Medina came out? Yeah, it came out in the 80s. Yeah, me too. I used to love the skating rink back in the day. So Brett says, Ricky, how many games are on the Beat It or Eat It wheel? On the last count, it's between 40 and 45. So there's plenty of retro games in the Beat It or Eat It wheel. I'll gradually add more in the future. Oh my gosh, we're going to do this. And what do we got? We got, what are you going to use? Oh, there we go. What was it, the wheel cutter? All right, cool. Hopefully we can get this sumbish. This is a pretty quick Mega Man game. I usually beat this in about an hour and 20 minutes these days. So we'll try and play the Stanley Parable for about a half an hour as well. I like Tony, that is cool, man. That Wild Thing was just a fun song. What movie was Wild Thing from again? There was a really, really big movie that had Wild Thing as one of the tunes. I forgot. But that's okay, Maddie. We'll see you again soon. Thank you for hanging out. Guys, don't forget, all we ask for coming in is you just give us a big thumbs up on the video if you can. Thank you, everybody. Smash that like button. As I said, treat the like button like you treat a nipple. Luther, that did not warrant a response. Hang on. Luther hasn't said anything yet. I apologize. All right. I probably shouldn't have brought it up anyway. All right, we're going to do Blade Man now. No, there's some comedy clubs in Ipswich. There's a lot of sit-down comedy clubs in Australia. Actually, I used to work for Callum Bale, and I used to work for a man that booked all the comedy club events in Queensland. I actually worked closely with the guy that booked the stand-up in Australia. So I've actually got the right contacts for stand-up comedy, believe it or not. And I know nothing about stand-up comedy. I just happen to have the contacts. But yeah, I the guy that I DJ'd for did all the comedy acts as well. And I hope he's doing alright since the My Sharona, actually. I should probably ring him. He's, I still have a good relationship with him. He's, an older guy, though, so his health might be a little bit jeopardized, you know? Oh, it was Uncle Buck. Okay, yeah. That's the one. Yes, it was Uncle Buck. Thank you, Jared. Man, well, good man. You've got a great memory, sir. It was Uncle Buck. Yeah, there you go. I knew it was in a big movie. I just couldn't remember which one. Wild Thing. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah, no, you're right. It was Uncle Buck. That's exactly the movie I was thinking about. Oh, my goodness. Back out here. I didn't even really need to jump on that, but that's fine. So it was also Major League, huh? I'm not really as familiar on Major League. I mean, I've seen it in passing, but... Not, I was never a big Major League guy. Used to watch Uncle Buck a lot, though. How good was Uncle Buck? Man, I miss John Candy. Oh, man. I used to just binge watch his movies all the time as a kid. I'd binge watch Cool Runnings. I'd binge watch Uncle Buck. I'd binge watch Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. I love Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. How good was that movie? What other good John Candy movie? There was Summer Rental. I haven't seen that in a long time. But I'll have to go back and watch that one. But yeah, it was Summer Rental, wasn't there? That's okay, Luther. You don't need to... How you going, Colin? Good to see you. DJ Jazzy Jeff, you see, they did all that harmless rap too. Yeah, Jazzy Jeff was awesome. I loved his cameos on the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, where he'd always get thrown out of the house. Always thought that was really funny. What was that guy again? That troublemaker. I'm doing pretty good, thank you, Colin. I appreciate you, man. I hope you're having a good day. What time is it in the UK right now? Oh gosh. You watch Major League more than Uncle Buck? Yeah, I was more of an Uncle Buck guy. No, we gotta do this one. Fine, cool. I don't have save states in this. I keep going to press the save state button and, okay, no, we do have to go on this little seesaw. That sucks. That's fine. Here you go. On the seesaw, mate. On the seesaw. Fuckadoo, fuckadoo. Excuse me. Does whatever a fuckadoo does. Excuse me. Dan, I hate this little... Oh my gosh, this little fuckhead piss off. Excuse me, guys, but he is a little fudgehead. Alright, let's go. Goodness. What's this about Jazz? What's it? Everyone's bringing up Jazz. What's this Jazz business? Why is this going over my head? Oh, Jazz. Yeah, of course. Sorry, guys. Yeah, now I remember. Fresh Prince. Sorry. I like you just always get thrown out of the house. Because he was a sumbish. Always getting Will up to no good. That was good TV back in the day. I love going back and watching all those from time to time. I've seen every episode of The Fresh Prince, even though I don't remember all of them great. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna have to go back to the shop and buy more things. Alright, we're out of here. So what are we gonna use this time? We're gonna use the, okay, the commando bombs, no problem. Yeah, Spaceballs was great too, of course. Yeah, John Candy's in Spaceballs, but... I keep forgetting that he's in Spaceballs because he's dressed up as a dog. But yeah, no, he is, of course. He's a mog. He's his own best friend, mate. Oh, okay, I kind of screwed that one up, but that's fine. Oh, dude, come on, weak. There's that. There you go. Boom. Done. Good morning, Steve. Thank you for coming in, enjoying some coffee. You are? I can't have no more caffeine. I've got to go to bed after this. Hey, go on, Edgar. Good to see you. Wallace? Fresh Prince sucked once the first Aunt Viv left. The second Aunt Viv was crap. I thought the second Aunt Viv was a MILF, to be honest. Does that make me wrong? I don't know. I thought she was kind of popping. Anyway, I'm going to leave that one alone. And, Peyron, thank you very much. Peyron with 100 stars. I really, really appreciate you. This is going out to you. Peyron loves Cool Runnings as well. Man, that's such a classic movie. That just goes to show that a G-rated movie can be absolutely fantastic. Like, some of these family movies are wonderful. I do get that the first Aunt Viv was a bit more entertaining because she definitely had a spunk about her, but that was part of the reason she got fired. She was a bit of a hothead, kind of like OneCoin here. I did see a few stories about why Aunt Viv got fired. I know she clashed a lot with Will Smith. I know they didn't get along too well. So Steven says Cool Runnings was based. No, you know, don't look. I used to believe everything I heard as a kid. Now, whenever a show says based on a true story, what that means is 10% of it is true and the other 90% is fiction. That, always remember that. If Hollywood says based on a true story, only like 1% of it needs to be true. So I saw an interview with Niki Lauda, you know, the guy, the Formula One world champion, after they did the movie The Rush. You know the movie Rush with Hemsworth and what's his name, about the Formula One drivers? And Niki Lauda says that was 80% true. And then you had the movie The Social Network, which came out in 2010. And Mark Zuckerberg don't think much of that is all that true. But, you know, he's going to say that, of course. Seth with 100 stars. Hey, thank you, Seth. I appreciate ya. Should be right with you. What are we going to give to Seth today? I'm going to find something. Here we go. We're going to do this one for you, my friend. Thank you, Seth. It should say inspired by a true story. I actually agree with that, actually. Seth, going out to you, man. Seth with 200 in total. Thank you so much, Seth. I actually agree with your point. By the way, the music in this level is my favorite. I love this soundtrack. It's just very carnival sounding. That's right, John Candy was also in Brewster's Millions, right? Good old Brewster's Millions. That was a cool movie too. That's a movie I need to go back and watch. I still don't know how someone spends all that money so quickly. It's pretty crazy. Just goes to show, like, it takes time to burn through that much money. Mind you, it seems really, really quick if, I don't know. Probably in 2020 it would be a lot easier to burn through. Depends on what Bollywood or Hollywood decides is entertaining, say how much is, but yeah, exactly. At the end of the day, they, you know, the true story is not always as interesting. How much do you reckon you will get a house in the Sydney CBD? Oh, dude. Bro, you're not going to get a house in the Sydney CBD, I don't think, for any less than $1.5 million, if I'm going to be honest. Not that I know anything about the housing market. But if you want to live in the CBD, you're paying $1.5 million, that's just something really small. I would guess. What do you think, Perry? Maybe Perry's a bit more familiar. Yeah, gosh, that's where all the rich people live. Guess that's going to be out of my price range. Yeah, $1.5 million for a box. It's like, you're living in Sydney in Australia is probably like living in San Francisco in the United States, just a heads up. Yeah, Sydney's kind of like our San Francisco. So what else is going on, guys? Any other news you got for me? How's everything looking in your neck of the woods with my Sharona? I hope everyone's keeping positive and happy and... Bad times don't last, guys. We're all going to go through this. One day at a time, hey? Peyron says you'd buy every single NES game if you had the money from Brewster's Millions. I don't want to own every single game. I just like to collect the games I'd like, I'd stream, or mean something to me. So once I've gotten the 60 or 70 games I like on one system, I'll go on to the next system and so forth. And then I'll just have a collection of all games that I actually like. But you know, that's my collecting strategy. Everyone's different. Get this sumbish. You live too close to the city of Melbourne in a one-bedroom box and you pay an absolute fortune. Man, the only place I could live in Sydney is in the CBD. Is in the CBD, like Bondi. But good luck. That's. Yeah. Do they have property taxes over here? There is. I don't. I mean, obviously, I'm not in so much into the whole real estate that I'm an expert on all that, so I'm not the right person to talk to. But yeah, you have to work about the extras. You have to work. There's extras over here. Of course, the government's going to try and get as much money as they can off you, mate. Of course, there is. Okay, so Mega Man got the Robo Enza here, guys. Poor Mega Man's really, really sick. And it's not good. It's not looking too good for Mega Man right now. Greetings, people of the world. I hope you're enjoying the effects of my little Robo Enza virus. See, he's evil. So So there you go. He's infected everybody in order for them to work for him. Jeez, that's, you know what? Damn, how's that for extortion? If you want to be cured, then you have to come work for me. Well, that really sucks. Alright, so how are we going to heal Mega Man? How are we gonna... There you go. Oh, look, we got a pill. Oh, that's alright. It looks like Mega Man's gonna be better. It was a trick all along. Yeah, that evil Dr. Wily. Sorry, I'm not gonna play out the... Man, I'm so sick of the cutscene. There you go. I'm gonna press the start button. Yes, Mega Man's better. He took a pill. Alright, we'll do the Wily stages now. So Brett says, you're going to try to start a playthrough of Final Fantasy X and try to do it with no death? Well, there you go, Brett. Good for you. Let me know how you get on, hey? Alright, guys. So this, we should be done with this in about 20 minutes. This is actually going to be an incredibly quick playthrough, which will probably be really good today, guys, because that'll give us some more time with the Stanley Parable, which is, as I said, is an absolutely fantastic game, so I hope you enjoy it. Once again, guys, thank you for all the star love today already. You've been incredible. Alright, let's go, Mega. You little blue miracle pill for the middle-aged man. I'm just going to use the pea shooter on this, because I can kill these things. I may as well. I mean, why use your sub-weapons if you don't have to? These things aren't the hardest things to kill in the world. Okay, Wooden Man's a little bit trickier, but... So Lauren says, you can't wait for Beetle Eater. I've been looking forward to bringing it back for a very long time. Sometimes you just need to give things a rest, so people miss them and look forward to them again. Like, you can't have too much of a good thing, so I'm kind of glad that we do Beetle Eater in seasons. So you guys have a rest from it, and then you miss the show. So, yeah, we'll do 10 or 20 episodes in this season, give another break, and then do a fourth season, you know? Did anyone ever request a PS game Irritating Stick? I think I know the game that you're... No, hang on, I'm thinking of Bubba and Sticks on Genesis. No, I've never seen that game. Lauren says, Ricky is such a businessman. Well, I'm still working on it. I mean, I have been in the entertainment industry for, what, 15 years? So I kind of know how things operate a little bit. Certainly no expert. Irritating Stick, that sounds interesting. Tell me more about that one, Maddie. So, Honkers, I'm doing pretty good, man. I've been a little bit tired lately, dude, but I think it's been all this terrible, terrible food I've been eating. You know, obviously, I'm on this Corona diet right now, which means a bunch of shit food just to get, you know, we're all comfort eating right now, so I think that's kind of drained me a little bit, so I just need to look after my diet. But apart from that, I'm doing pretty good, thanks, man. How about you, Ryan? What's going on? So Ryan says, can you see Commodore or D-Wayne do it a beat? Absolutely, you guys can. Well, I can't speak for Commodore, but I think D-Wayne will be a good sport and do one eventually. We'll work it out. Maybe when I go away, at the end of the year, if we get international travel back, then we can do it. We'll see. So Ryan says, gotta get you a home-cooked meal from Mum. Oh, I'd love a home-cooked meal. That's alright. When Tassie gets back up here, I'll just get her to make me a hot meal. Isn't that right, April? You're gonna cook for me? She'll make me some chicken adobo and she'll make everything better. I don't know if April's still in here. She'll be like, say what, Rick? Got our health back. Yeah, but you know, the thing is, like, You know how you were a spoiled little shit as a kid? And you'd always be like, you're cooking at home, I want McDonald's. You know, I was always so ungrateful for the home cooking as a kid, because I wanted McDonald's and pizza. And now I wish I had a home-cooked meal all the time. I really took good cooking for granted. Like, my grandmother always made pretty decent, healthy meals when I was growing up, and I didn't show enough appreciation for them back then. Oh, there you go, you got a female friend coming to drink. There you go, Honkers, that's what's up. April's still here. There you go, I'm in trouble now. Yes, well, that's going to be one of many trips. I want to travel for a long time and work while I travel, Perry, because you never know when it can get taken away from you again. So, yeah, I want to go to Vegas as much as other places, sir, and then just work while I'm away. As I said, I want to live life to the fullest, because you never know, if we have another outbreak one day, we're probably never allowed to travel overseas ever again, you know what I mean? Like, you don't know what tomorrow's going to bring. Not to be negative, but you just don't know. I'm going to, So April says when you get up, yeah, I wouldn't threaten me, April, or I'll take away your pancake points. I'm dead serious. Dean Douglas says the homemade meals are the best. Yeah, absolutely, dude. I love a good home-cooked meal now. And I love fried chicken, but I know a home-cooked meal is better for me. Oh, is the ganja illegal in Vegas now, is it? Well, there you go, you can have legal ganja on the strip. Ooh, that was close, wasn't it? Come on, Rick Dog, damn it. Oh, come on, Rick Dog. There we go. We got that sumbish. Awesome. Perry says you'll be over as soon as they let you. Me too, bro. As soon as restrictions are lifted, I am out of here. I'm not even kidding. All right, Honkers says you all just made me hungry. Lauren says if you ever go to... I want to see Niagara Falls once in my lifetime, Lauren. I would absolutely love to go to Niagara Falls. So Niagara Falls is like on the Canadian border, isn't it? Or am I mistaken? she'll get me on Mario Kart, you're right. She will. No, I think it's not for our audience, Hitmonkey. I have Destiny 2 and I have all the expansions for it. But I don't think our audience is a very instant gratification audience for the most part. I don't think Destiny would do too well with the regulars, and they're not in it because you know that everyone does Call of Duty, Apex, Destiny, Fortnite. You know, I'm trying to steer away from those kind of games, so I'm going to respectfully decline. That's just not really what I mean. I've been tempted to do a Destiny stream, but I decided against it. It's on the America. Okay, I thought so. Yep. So, Perry, yeah, ganja is very illegal in Australia. You're allowed to grow it, and you know, what's really, really funny about Australia is the only legal place that you can grow it is actually in the capital where Parliament is, which is really funny. Probably because all the politicians are on the ganja, I don't know. Then Luther says Destiny wouldn't hold a room. I tend to agree with you, my friend. And then, you know, I say that with a lot of sadness because I do like Destiny. Nah, man, I have to unfortunately look. You know, now that one coin only is at a certain size, like I want to stream the games that you guys like, but it has to be like what the majority likes, because you know, streaming's a results based shtick. You know what I mean? I can't play games that tank because our channel will get penalized. And I'm not going to name names, but you've seen lots of people in our community that used to get really, really big results that don't anymore. And that's because they're not playing by Facebook's rules. So it's just one of those things. If we're going to survive, we have to play ball. Lauren says Destiny's a D-Wayne game. I try to explain this to people, but they don't get it. Ryan says you're about to eat chicken and dumplings. Oh, dude, that sounds amazing right now. crap. Okay, I'm just trying to wait for this. You got to be on the gungeon to actually like working with ScoMo. Yeah. Oh my gosh. I'm not getting political. I'm just talking as a human being now. But I do feel for him a little bit right now. I would not want to be in his position during this global crisis. This is, and with everything going on with China, man, this is a really freaking tough situation. I would not want to be in his shoes. I'm better him than me. That's all I'm going to say. Better freaking him than me. Oh my gosh. Patrick with another 100 stars. Thank you very much, Patty. Good to see you. Hey, we got Haley in here. Good to see you, Haley. Thank you, Patrick. Patrick dropping the big 100. What can we give to Patrick this time? Let's have a look down here. This one for you, Pat. Thank you, my man.
Let's get dangerous.
Yeah, exactly. See, I like to chill out with Destiny sometimes in my own time. But yeah, like you said, Lou, but... you know, that's kind of a game I like to... I want to start playing with my brother-in-law just to chill out with. Like, Matthew loves Destiny. You guys see Matthew here quite a lot. Yeah, no, exactly, off the clock. I'd be happy to play with you, Luther, and Luther Hitmonkey, sure. I'm doing pretty good, Nick, thank you, man. I'm in a pretty good mood here. We're just having some fun. Some Bishami just having a good time today. Sebastian says, oh, Ricky, ended your... 2K16 stream out of rage. It wasn't that hard, but obnoxious people really piss me off sometimes, and if people are pissing me off, I'm not gonna stay on the stream. It's that simple. You know, when you're flooded with people with obnoxious opinions and you know, backseat gaming, I'm gonna be like, you know what, fuck those guys, I'm not hanging around. Life's too short to put up with the negativity all the time. Got zero tolerance now, like none, zero. What do I think about Rey Mysterio? Hang on, when's Rey Mysterio retiring? What do you mean? When's he retiring? I don't know what. What are you talking about, Peyron? I actually, I've got to thank Commodore, because Commodore just actually got the records off speedrun.com, and apparently I've got the 88th fastest recorded finishing time for Resident Evil 3 in the world, which means I've got the top 100 time, which doesn't sound like a big deal, but I think that's pretty freaking sweet still. So big thank you to Commodore for showing me that. There you go, Rick's in the top 100 in Resi. I never thought that would happen. Mind you, I'm sure there's been like thousands of people that have the same time or quicker, but they just haven't recorded it, you know, but still pretty cool. Yeah, Honkus was my first ever, and you remember the game it was, Honkus? Tell everyone what the first game I ever rage quitted from was. Oh, good on you. How's your daughter going, by the way, Gareth? She okay? Thank you, Nick. I appreciate that. I wasn't trying to prove anything to anyone. I was only going for an hour, so my new record time for Resident Evil 3 is 1 hour and 4 minutes and 13 seconds. And I wasn't trying to, like, get any world records or anything. I'm just trying to prove to myself that I can get under an hour. But yeah, it turns out I'm in the top 100 times. I'm like, that's pretty cool. Oh, that's really, really cool. Life Force, it was. Hey, thank you, Patrick. Patrick says for being in the top 100. Here's another 100 stars for you. Thank you, Patty. I appreciate that. Patty, you're dropping in like it's hot today. I'm gonna have to pull up those pants to hold in all those stars that I'm putting in my pockets now. Thank you, Patty, man. That's a lot of stars this stream. Appreciate ya. I don't even know what you... Oh, goodness. Aaron also dropping the... Man, you guys are awesome. Thank you. Aaron also with big 500. Oh, my gosh. Give me 1 second here, guys. I'm just trying to freaking beat this up-ish. I think the next level's a really hard one. Damn it, you motherfucker. Excuse me. Sorry. I shouldn't say that word so much, but... I like to go all Samuel L. Jackson sometimes, guys. What can I tell ya? Us Aussies like to drop a few F-bombs here and there, if you didn't, and maybe even a C-bomb or two, you know what I'm saying? Which shocks a few of my Yankee friends, but, you know, it's just part of the culture. Nothing to take offense at. Aaron, my dude, thank you again for the big 500 stars. All right, we're going to go a bit hip-hop on you today. And, what do we got? Where's my hip-hop screens? There we go. This, where is it? This one. I'm gonna do two for Aaron. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Coast, are you in the house? Japan, are you in the house? Everybody, are you in the house? Well, I tell you what, Aaron's in the house today. Thank you again, brother. Man, I love the ODB. We have a new US champion, yeah, man. I'm kind of happy about that. Let's see what they do with the guy, hey? I was gonna quickly go to the shop and buy a couple things. So we're gonna buy just a couple of these, yes. What's this one do? Oh, that'll do. Let's get out. So Jared says dropping F-bombs is as natural as drinking cold beer here in Aussie. See, we use it in polite conversation over here. Are you sure today? See, that's what we have to put up with in Mega Man 11. That's probably my least favorite thing in Mega Man 11. And Peyron says Apollo Crews is the new US champion. Yes, indeed he is. Peyron, again, thank you for the big 100. I'm going to be right with you. All right, what we got for Peyron today? Let me have a look at this one. Man, I loved Astro Boy back in the day. I'm going to have to go back and watch some of those again. Thank you again, Peyron. This is Mega Man 10 right now. We're pretty close to the end of the game. We just got a couple levels left, and then we're going to do Stanley Parable as a bonus. So this stream might end up being just a little bit shorter in 2 hours today, actually. But it depends how long we stay on Stanley Parable for. But we should at least get about 30 minutes from Stanley Parable. And I hope you guys hang around for that game, because it's actually really fun. It's an awesome experience. I haven't done it in a long time, so it's going to seem really fresh again. Steven says, here's 100 stars for some more Old Dirty Bastard. All right, brother, I'm going to do Old Dirty Bastard for you one more time. I tell you what, though, he's got nothing on Rick James. I really love to chase her. I've got so there was 52 episodes, I think, in the 1980s series, Jared, if I'm not mistaken, 52 episodes, or it's 54 or something. Anyway, I've got the first half on DVD. I need to get the second half, but I've got like the first 20 something episodes on DVD, which is still pretty cool. But yeah, they're in my room too. My sister got them for me one Christmas, actually, so thank you, Megan. She knows how much I love Astro Boy. Big part of my childhood. He won the title against Andrade Ciamalmes, but yeah, Andrade didn't really do a whole lot with it during his suspension, and I think it was good to do something different with it. I think it was time to jump. Let's see how we go. And then Honkus wants some Rick Astley. You got it, brother. Thank you, Honkus. Honkus with a 100. Just to go on top of the 50 million this month, brother. Thank you so much. I'll be right with you, Honkus. Never going to give you up. And you know what? This sounds like a political campaign, which is the running joke. Let's see if we can find it. Here you go, Honkus. If it works. I think so, Brian. Thank you again, my brother. I can't wait till I have this new computer, because I'm starting to get lag on my thank you screens. But once I have my new computer and Stream Deck, it'll be instantaneous. Bang, bang, bang. Man, I can't wait, bro. By August, September, the production quality of 1.0 only is going to just be another step up. I'm very, very excited. Very, very excited for the future, guys. Not that I think what we're doing's bad, but you know, you can't rest on your laurels, mate. You gotta always evolve and improve. Yeah, Andrade was, I don't know, he was on the Gunter as well, wasn't he? Maybe him and Charlotte were doing the old recreational drugs while they were partying in Vegas before My Sharona, I'm not sure. Damn, I tell you what, Andrade and Charlotte must get a bit freaky. You know what's really awkward? Is Charlotte looks like that if Andrade went out of line that she could beat the living piss out of him. That sounds really bad to say. But I don't know, man. I have a funny feeling that Charlotte wears the pants in that relationship. Alright, we're gonna go back over here. And I'm just gonna keep playing the game before I get in trouble. Oh my goodness. Alright, back over them, yeah. Oh, your sister named your dog Astro after Astro Boy. Who's your best friend? You still tear up talking about him. Yeah, I think about, yeah, I had a... I feel real bad. I'm going to be really deep with you guys. I had a lot of traumatic experiences growing up, mainly in regards to bullying as a kid, that I kind of learned to turn myself off of a lot of emotion, which is a bad thing. Like, I still feel empathy, but I'm not very good at feeling a deep, deep sorrow at things that mean a lot to me, just because I've put a big, massive wall up as, like, a defense mechanism. Like, for example, I really, really miss my childhood dogs to death. They were lovely dogs. But then I try not to think about it too much, and I've kind of trained myself how to do that, you know, which is probably not a good thing. But, yeah. I messed up, guys. I'm really messed up. I'm sorry. what can you do, huh? I just gotta... What are we gonna do? The little balls here? Oh, there we go. We got this. Oh, there we go. We're gonna do these sumbitches. Oh, we might get them straight away. Oh, fantastic! Death by Schnurr-Schnurr? Oh, that's right, she was apparently really abusive too. I remember that back, she was like the ECW manager before it was NXT, if I'm not mistaken. Well, she was ECW manager before it became NXT, right? Yeah, apparently she was a nasty piece of work, that one. Thank you, Seb, I really appreciate ya. Over here. Yeah, she was ECW GM, I thought so. And then she went to TNA for a bit, didn't she? Yeah, that's all good. I've just learned how to put up a really, really, really big wall. Like, I'm an emotional guy, but in certain situations, like, the wall just comes up by itself, and it sort of just, like, well, like, protects me, I guess. The only cartoon voiced by B. Arthur. Which cartoon was that? Yeah, she was pretty tidy, wasn't she? She was cute. I know what Drew McIntyre was thinking about when he... Anyway, I'm gonna leave that alone. Alright, so we'll start from up here and work our way around, I guess. Yeah, exactly, Nick. I do care about all you guys. I just want all you guys to be healthy and happy, huh? Life's hard enough as it is without being even more negative. I'm glad you guys can see this as a positive in your day. If you didn't, I'm really not doing my job. Oh, crap. God damn you. And so, well, there you go, Luther. Jesus, man. What the... Oh, Luther, bro. Thank you for sharing that with the class, bro. Oh, we were talking about John Candy before. I think you're on a bit of a... Wow, Gareth, I think you're on a big delay, my friend. We were talking about that, but a while back. But yeah, we were talking about John Candy, the boys. He was awesome, Zaws. Oh no, maybe you aren't on a delay. Okay. Steven says, on a positive note, your second monitor comes today. Wait, how many inches did you get your monitor? And how much did it cost you, Steve, if you don't mind me asking? Because I want to get a computer monitor with my, So what I'll be doing is, when I get my, When I get my computer monitor, I'm going to, when I get my new laptop, I'm going to get a computer monitor as well. But I haven't shopped around yet. Oh, we got this. John Candy was kind of creepy in that movie, but I loved it. It was a great movie. I used to watch that on repeat. I watched Planes, Trains, and Automobiles again just the other night. Probably about last week I watched that again. Let's put this down over here. Oh wait, that's the wrong one. Whoops. Totally the wrong one. What are you doing there, Rick? 24-inch. See, I'm probably looking for at least mine's going to be expensive because I think I need at least 30 inches. Wow, that's what she said. Anyway, I think I want to grab around 27, 30, something like that. I want something like really big, but not too big. Hey, go on, David. Good to see you. I just need to make sure that the refresh rate and response rate is really good. But yeah, I'll suss it out. See, that's what I'm kind of looking into. Maybe like a 34-inch curved monitor, perfect. So what's the response time on your monitor, and how much did it cost you, Nick? Do you think it's worthwhile? Is there any input delay or anything, or is it instantaneous? That's kind of what I'm after. I think 34 would be plenty. Yeah. Luther says, don't we all want something big? Yes, indeed we do, bro. Big heart and big dreams. Wait, what? Don't forget to please click the thumbs up, guys, if you haven't yet. I appreciate it. We're going to make our goal for this stream 150 likes. We are almost on 100, which is fantastic, everybody. You love yours? Let me know some more details later, Nick. Steven says your main monitor is 32, you paid 300, and it's a nice monitor. Yeah, I think 32 inches would be enough. Plus, if I need to go on the go, I could probably travel with it bubble-wrapped in my suitcase. If I ever take my streaming rig with me somewhere. No, I think 32 inches is what I need. Never trust a big butt and a smile. You might have to watch some of those some of those ECW shows were a train wreck, but that was part of the appeal. Man, you know what? The last hour before I came on, I had a free hour, and I was a little bit bored. And I started watching back through those old 90 Day Fiancé on YouTube. Jesus, man. I tell you what, I thought some of my past relationships were bad. They're all a picnic compared to this 90 Day Fiancé bullshit. Anyway. Oh, there you go, Brian. Whatever works for you, my friend. One more here. Hey, we got Matthew in here. Aloha. Good to see you, Matt. How you doing today? You good? We're just doing some Mega Man 10 here, and then we're going to do some Stanley Parable, which we are almost up to, actually, already. We've got plenty of time to do Stanley Parable today. See, I was going to buy an Ace of Predator as well, but I need more juice. I need more juice than that. A GTX, what's the 2000 model now? Like, I need 8 gig of video. I need 32 gig of RAM. Best processor I can possibly get in the laptop. I need to do a lot of things with this thing. I need it to run a NASA's, shuttle. So, Yeah, probably going a bit overboard. All right, let's go. I think this is it. You have a good one too, Perry. Thank you so much for coming in. Stanley Parable is like a walking simulator. It's like, unlike other walking simulators, this Stanley Parable game is like quick and to the point. A playthrough only takes 5 to 10 minutes, but it's got multiple branching paths and different ways to explain the story. And it's just really cool. I think you guys are going to like it for a little gimmicky game. It's fun. It's a good time. It's a perfect game just to kill 30 minutes. And it's not one of those games that you go back and play all the time. But it's some good storytelling. And it's a little bit whack in parts too. Yeah. As I said, I need some help finding the best computer possible. I need some help. So it's not my strong suit. I'm just gonna keep shooting this sumbitch. Alright, we're gonna got this tank here again. Where's this Did I end up here we go, gonna put this in here. Here we are. No, Jared, that's all good. I understand. I know it's starting to get a bit late in Aussie. When did Stanley Parable come out? Probably about it's not a new game, it's been around for at least 5-6 years at the very least. I mean, I think it might even be older than that, to be honest. So it's, yeah, I'd say 5 or 6 years. Kyle says, what time is it here? It's 20 past 12 in the morning, my friend. Yeah, 20 past 12 in the morning. Alright, I'm just gonna go back here. I'm just totally using all these. Alright, here we go. One more. She says it's too. 34 is too big, huh? I'm pretty sure it's not. I think 34 is perfect, mate. Alright, there we go. We're just gonna go back to the Buster over here. Ah, damn it. One more shot. You freaking kidding me? T-Blade. Yeah, I'm not very good at aiming with that sumbish. You think T-Blade's the best in this one? Oh, next time I'll try it out. Is it all gone now? Try and get a bare bones. No, I don't trust myself building a computer. Plus, I want to outsource this shit and make sure it's done properly by an expert. You know what I mean? Sometime, I don't know. I'm going to outsource it. I want it done properly. Also, Matthew says you just got done with your workout, now time to relax with Mega Man. Well, you came in time for the final boss, but as I said, we have a bonus game coming after this. While he's taking the balls to the face, he is. So, Joey's Stanley Parable is a really, really fun walking simulator. Like, playthrough goes for 5 to 10 minutes, has branching paths, and it's just got a very entertaining narration. It's just a nice chill game. Thought I'd show you guys today. You guys are all asking what Stanley Parable is. Well, fucking wait 5 minutes and you guys can find out for yourselves. Only kidding, but we're very close. Very, very close. I know you guys are excited. I like that you guys are hyped for it. It's a good sign. Damn it, you son of a bitch. That's karma for being an angry fudge. Good night to you too, Ryan. You have a great sleep, my friend. God, out here we go. And I think the boss is just down these stairs. The final boss. I think you need to use the lightning thing in this one, don't you? April says you've been waiting an hour. Is that the game that you came in specifically for? What if I changed my mind and decided not to play it, April? That'd be a dick move, wouldn't it? There you go, that's a bit of a dick move, Rick. I can't remember, here we go. So here we go, this is the final boss just down here, I think. Probably never, Brian. Look at Brian being all demanding here. When I fucking feel like it. Trying to figure out, we're gonna use, the wall here, I think, isn't it? Oh, yeah, I think. Okay, hang on. Oh wait, okay, you gotta get the one in the black, my bad. The shadow one you have to get. Alright, there we go. Oh, that is that not doing any damage? Okay, maybe that's not the... What are we gonna do against this guy? Okay, I don't know what weapon he's weak against. Maybe it's like C-bombs. The Australians know a thing or two about C-bombs. Damn it, hang on. No, that's not working. What are we gonna use? Maybe the striker? I'm not getting any damage off it. What are we gonna use? Maybe the water shield, isn't it? That's right, it's a water shield, I think. No, it's not the water shield either. What's he weak against? Maybe it's a sunblade. No, I'm still not taking any damage off it. Well, that's not working. What are we supposed to do? What am I missing here, guys? Maybe the pea shooter is all I can use on this one. Maybe it has to be the pea shooter. Let's try the pea shooter. Why can't I kill him? What am I doing wrong? I don't get it. What am I doing? Alright, I'm not taking any health off him. We'll use a weapon that comes from... Stop it with your metaphorical fucking stuff. Oh my goodness. D-Wayne with the philosophical stuff, not the metaphorical stuff, sorry. Maybe I've got to use the spikes, let's try this again. Oh my gosh, why can't I get this sumbish? Oh, okay, so you do have to get the one in the white, okay. Alright, well there you go, the spikes are working. Jeez, man. How you going, Alex? You having good? You doing good? What we got? Okay, another couple shots, almost there. Use the power friendship. Well, being a Mortal Kombat guy, D-Wayne knows a thing or two about the power of friendship. Oh my gosh, that was a mess, but we finally did it, guys. Oh, good to hear you. Good, Alex. Thank you for popping in. Just a nice cruisy stream to start the day. Don't mind me, guys. I'm just going to quickly on these subs. Don't forget, supporters comes with benefits, guys. Don't forget to click on that green shield in your leisure. Use a Schwartz. Oh, there you go now. Poor Dr. Wily's got the Robo Enza, guys. Look, he's going all purple. The old guy's got the My Sharona. Aaron, thank you. Aaron dropping another 200. The Robo Ember, yeah, look, it looks like it serves him right. Thank you, Daniel. April also dropping the 200. Thank you, Apes. Big thank you to Aaron and to April. I'm going to be right with you guys. A few days later, what's going to happen? They're treating Dr. Wily. He flies away. He escapes. Supporter is like friends with benefits. Oh, gosh. There you go. D-Wayne's pimping me out like his favorite bottom bitch. Alright, that'll do. That's all over. So, Alex and April, thank you very much. This is going out to you guys. I'm getting pimped out like D-Wayne's bottom bitch. Patrick says the power of the hot... Oh, gosh. Do I have to do the hot dog dance? I have to do the hot dog dance. Alright, fine. Alright, here we go. Look at me! Look at me! Look at me! Look at me! I had to do the hot dog dance. Thank you very much for helping me make a fool of myself again, Patrick. Alright, let me load the next game. I'm almost there. Stanley Parable. Load this sumbish up. Shut this window down. And, okay. I am going to have to readjust my YouTube chat box here, guys. Just put that down here. I might miss a comment here or there. Forgive me. Stanley Parable. Alright, so, alright, we're gonna go begin the game. This is really, really cool. I hope you enjoy it. And, let me know if this is all working. I think it is. I'm just gonna make sure the volume's alright. Oh, I accidentally crashed it. Well, that's not good, is it? That might rectify itself in a sec. I think I just crashed the game by accident. Ah, damn it, I crashed the game. Oh, damn it, it fucking crashed. Oh, there you go, this is like whatever Wednesday, but like a normal stream. Alright, there we go, I'm just gonna move this up here. Alright, we're gonna try this again, it won't crash this time. Is it true that I'm up to 5,000 subscribers on OnlyFans, Matt asks? No, it's rumored. Alright. If you'd like, D-Wayne, if you feel the need to. Timmy dropping 100 stars too. Timmy, thank you so much. And a very good morning. How was the rest of your shift? You think the hot dog dance should come with a minimum of 500? Hey, bro, it'd be a good way for me to make a lot of money, wouldn't it? So Brian says, play some Zelp. Don't you start getting needy on me, Brian, or I'm going to kick you in the beanbags by cracky. So there's a little bit of a load time here, guys. Hopefully this will work. I've never had problems with this game before. Now, Timmy, I've got a not responding message. I don't know why this is not responding. Oh, why is... Okay, now it's working. Damn, the load time is massive. No, I'm not going to actually do that, Nick. That was just a joke. The load time's taking... it's taking a while to load. We'll be there. Give me... Did I end up getting drug dealer sim, Alex asked me. No, I thought I'd better not. I definitely wouldn't stream it. Almost loaded. Man, so I forgot the loading times.
This is the story of a man named Stanley.
Alright, here we go. Timmy, I haven't forgotten about you.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427.
How's the volume, guys?
He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what
Aaron.
To push.
I've got to listen to the narrator now, bruh. Aaron with the big 500, thank you, bro. 427
did every day. Every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
Stanley was happy with his mediocre job, and then one day, you know, just the average Joe. Happened.
Something that would forever change Stanley.
Now what's
something
he gonna do?
He would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk.
Hey, go! We got Sylvain in here. Good to see you, Sylvain. Yeah, I'm gonna do the hot dog dance one more time. Don't worry. So this is the intro, and so Stanley's got up now, and now we're gonna basically start the game. It needs a bit more volume. No worries, guys. You just have to let me know these things. Alright, so I'm actually going to go the options and adjust the video a little bit. I think, medium. Yeah, I need it to run a little bit better. I think that's a problem I've been having. Alright, here we go. I'm going to move this up here. Give me one second, guys. Alright, so this one's going out to both Timmy... And, hang on one second. And, this one's going out to Timmy, to Aaron, just making sure I didn't miss anyone else. All right, here we go. I'm a hot dog. Look at me. Look at me. All right. Thank you, guys. I'm a hot dog. And also this one for Timmy. Thank you very, very much, the stars, guys. Take Stanley to the break room, get donuts first. I think there is a staff room in this. I think. All right, here we go. So we're going to go back, resume the game. All right, cool. All right, this is running a lot better now.
All his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Perhaps. Oh, so I've got to turn the... Oh, gosh. Sorry, guys. I'm all over the place here. Got to turn the volume up. There we go. I might need to change... Man, this is not really performing too well, is it? Let me just change these video options one more time. Video. Advanced. And I'm just going to put this all on low. For some reason, it's not running so fantastic. I don't know why. I've got a super freaking awesome computer here. At least for this game. Oh, dude, are you fucking kidding me? Oh, it just fucking crashed. Oh, motherfucker. Alright, there you go. Fuck. Anyway, it's all fixed now. Yeah, see, look how quick it's loading, because I don't have the high graphics settings on it. Sylvain says this looks like a fun game. It is. Here we go. Alright, now we're starting again. Alright, so now we're out of the office. Alright, let's go. We got this. It's running at full speed now. Fantastic. We can do it.
What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room.
Alright, we're going to go to the meeting room. The memo. More hot dog. No, we're okay. So you're just going to go through the open doors.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Okay.
Ah, yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all.
You think that'd be a big plot twist, wouldn't it?
Immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley,
how you going, LA Evans? Good to see you.
Drinking it all in.
All right. Let's keep going this way, I guess.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
So we can either listen to the rules or not listen to the rules. All right, we'll go in here.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
I love the narrator. It's so posh. All right. This is the meeting room,
yet,
I guess.
There was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Okay, let's go to the boss's office. Is this the right way? That's a big-ass freaking office building, isn't it? Now where?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Now, fuck the boss. We're going downstairs. We're going downstairs. Now what?
But Stanley just couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss, admitting he had left his post during work hours. He might be fired for that. And in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk? All because he believed everyone had vanished.
D-Wayne says you want to work at Stanley's place to stop. Yeah, no people.
Maybe, he thought to himself.
How you going, Bill? How you been keeping Mr. Del Rio? I hope you're doing great.
Blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment for no reason at all. None of it made any logical sense. And as Stanley pondered this, he began to make other strange observations.
I love strange games like this.
Why couldn't he see his...
This is only on PC, I think, Sylvain, I think.
Why did doors close automatically behind him?
I don't think this ever came out in console.
And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar. Were they simply repeating? No, Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange. This can't be real. And at last, he came to the conclusion that had been on the tip of his tongue.
Oh, we're going in circles.
He hadn't found the words for it. I'm dreaming, he yelled. This is all a dream. Oh, what a relief Stanley felt to have finally found an answer, an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all. And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring
life. Well, thank you, Joey. Oh, you're talking to D-Wayne. I thought you were talking to me. Well, I'm glad to hear, Bill. Still lucid.
So, he imagined himself flying and began to gently float above the ground.
Holy shit, this is so whack.
Then he imagined himself soaring through space on a magical star field, and it too appeared. It was so much fun, and Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up. How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head.
What? This is
one
whack.
He was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking?
Too much Foster's
now
beer.
Now the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice.
A Stanley parable. Sorry, Patrick.
Thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought. And while he thought it all very odd and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not a dream. How could it be? Was Stanley simply deceiving himself, believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself? Stanley is as awake
really deep
right now as he's ever been in his life. Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite a shock to Stanley.
Well, how the fuck do I get out?
He knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was in fact a dream. Did the voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a moment ago? How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too. Surely, if he could just... He would prove it.
Wake up, Stanley!
He would prove that he was in control, that this was a dream. So he closed his eyes gently, and he invited himself to wake up.
Okay, wake up, Stanley.
The cool weight of the blanket on his skin. The press of the mattress on his back.
It's hard to explain because depending on the direction you take in this, because you can take multiple branching paths in this, and depending on the path you take, it's a different genre. One can be kind of a bit horror-ish. It can be philosophical. It can just be... it's weird. It depends on the path that you take.
And my wife.
Good night, Jared. You take care, my brother. Thank you for coming in.
All I want is my life exactly.
We got Justin. Good to see you.
My life is normal. I am normal. Everything will be fine. I am okay.
Okay, now is he going to wake up? Now we're still here.
Stanley began screaming. Please, someone, wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who am I?
Blackity!
Black.
Now what?
This is the story of a woman named Mariella. Mariella woke up on a day like
another. I thought this was about Stanley.
She rose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk.
Oh.
And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance...
Sure, Joey, I will in a sec.
For brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy. This much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal.
You're not wrong, Sylvain.
I am in control.
Yeah, we're going to do a different adventure next time.
I know what is real and what isn't.
We're going to play this a few times, just so you can see a few different endings.
Way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day. The very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career. And by extension, the rest of her life.
I guess that's dead
she
Stanley.
Had no time for this. So it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body. And then she turned and ran.
Damn, that's... this game is a bit whack, isn't it? In a very good way. Alright, I guess we're going to try and do a different story this time. That's the first one. That was something else, wasn't it? Oh, here we go. This is part two. So you get to part two
all of his
here.
All his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
So what we're going to do is what we'll do this time is we'll obey every single command.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
All right, there we go. We'll go on the door on the left. Let's go, Stanley.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office.
So we'll go to the boss's office this time. All right, off to the boss's office.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
All right. What up, boss? Executive bathroom, can we take a piss? No. This is all hoity-toity, isn't it? Damn, this is like Mr. Burns's office.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded
Stanley.
The terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845.
All right.
But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
There we go.
Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons.
Patrick, thank you for the 100 stars. I'll be with you in a sec, my friend. Thank you very much.
By sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Where's the passageway at? Newly opened passageway, hey? All right, where is it? I can't see no passage. Here. Okay, sweet. Wait, no, this is not the garage again, is it? Oh, it's going to probably take us down. Oh, okay, let's go in here. Push the big red button. Now where do we go? Okay, maybe we don't go that way. Maybe we're gonna go in here. Where the fuck are we supposed to go? It's all a bit dark, this one, isn't it? Oh, we do have to press the red button. Okay. Oh, goodness. While the game's loading, guys, this has gone out to Patrick one more time. You're welcome, my friend. I know, man, you're going to be so sick of hot dogs by tomorrow, man. Seriously. Everyone gets sick of hot dogs sooner or later.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long.
Alright, so where do we go now? Alright. Oh, okay. Let's have a look-see roundsies here.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read.
Well, that doesn't look too good, does it?
Facility.
Yeah, she's And the mouse is causing me a few problems here. There we go, that's better. It's not looking too good right now. What's over on this computer? A big gigantic light bulb, eh?
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens.
She says lots of things,
what
Nick.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
I'm going to do one more ending for you after this, guys. And we're going to what am I going to do for the next one? I'm probably going to completely ignore everything next time. Well, what do you do over here? Do we need to go downstairs or something? I don't know. Like, do we have to use a computer or something? It's like...
Now the monitors
Came
to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the
damn
building.
Bro. Stanley's this looks like New York
the
Customs.
The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally...
St. Patrick says you ate hot dogs and ramen like your entire deployment to Korea for lunch. That will never get old, but ODB... Patrick, thank you for another 100 stars, my brother. Really, that's awesome. So what we could do, we're going to go this way now. Okay. This reminds me of that show Vegas with James Caan. This reminds me of what? Las Vegas. All the cameras.
This mind control facility. It was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason?
It does look a little bit like the Batcave, doesn't it?
That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Yeah, I knew that there was a new Ledger Shoot Larry out. Hey, go on, Susan. Good to see you. I knew there was a new Ledger Shoot Larry out. I just can't really stream those games too much.
He couldn't accept it.
Facebook restrictions and all that, you know.
In someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
All right, now what are we going to do? More computers. Okay.
The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions. Happy, or sad, or content. Walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from this very place.
Uh-huh.
And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in,
uh-huh,
Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life.
All right.
For he would dismantle the controls once and for
deep.
All.
All right, let's turn the power off. Or we can be an evil mastermind if we want. No, we'll turn it off. Or we'll do good for humankind. Oh my goodness. So Sylvain says it looks like the Twilighty Zone. Yeah. Now what?
Blackness.
It is
and
very
a rising
dark.
Chill of uncertainty. Was it over?
Yes, I know, Luther, but that's what
yes.
Red Tube is for.
He had won. He had defeated the machine. Unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away. And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many...
You like your Here You Go song? Make that a star
screen.
Mr. Drew, thank you for the 100 stars as well. I'm still going to give something to you and Patty.
What other mysteries did this strange building hold? But as
here we go,
none of this mattered to him. For it was
maybe I need to find a cartoon character to double something.
Seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No
well, that's
longer
pretty deep,
would anyone
isn't
tell
it?
Him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his. And that was all.
That's really, really deep.
Know. It was perhaps the only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door.
All right, Stanley, get out of here.
Stanley,
now where are we going to go?
Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin. The feeling of liberation. The immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.
Well, that's probably the best ending because we did what we were told. So let's see what fucked up ending we get next. We're going to do it one more time. Oh my gosh, what an interesting game. Pat and Mr. Drew, thank you very much. This has gone out to you guys once again.
Japan,
Mr. Drew. I really appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. We're going to go back here. And Patty says, and that was the first time Stanley tipped acid. Emilio!
What is
man, that's a lot of stars today, Patrick, dude. You're the man. Seriously, thank you. You're spoiling me. Oh, I stayed in the office, so I get another ending.
What if he had to make a decision? What if a crucial outcome fell
under his
responsibility?
Yeah, I forgot you can stay in the office. That's an ending, too.
He had never been trained for that.
And then Timmy says some bedtime stars. Timmy, thank you, brother. Have a good sleep.
The thing to do now, Stanley thought to himself, is to wait. Nothing will hurt me.
Give me one second, Timmy.
In here I can be happy forever. I will be happy. Stanley waited. Hours passed, then days. Had years gone by? He no longer had the ability to tell. But the one thing he knew for sure, beyond any doubt, was
that
if he waited long enough,
the answers
would come.
Do I know how many endings are in there? I think it's probably around 10 or something.
They would arrive. Soon, very soon now, this will end. He will be spoken to. He will be told what to do. Now it's just a little bit closer. Now it's even closer. Here it comes.
Oh, there you go. Let's go mad with power. All right, so I'm going to pause here. And this one's gone out to Timmy. Timmy, we'll see you in the morning. Well, in the evening, I should say. All right, guys, will you take the red pill or the blue pill? Yeah. All right, so, guys, what we're going to do this time is we're going to ignore everything.
Stanley knew the office layout like the back of his hand. It was only a matter of time before he found the others.
Right, so we're going to ignore everything.
Just a matter of time.
Okay, so we're in this main room again.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
No, we're going to go on the door on the right.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Nope.
Wow. Yes. This room. What a beautiful room. What a gorgeous, gorgeous room.
That's not
Thank
that
goodness Stanley had taken this detour on his way to the meeting room. Life without having experienced this, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nah, we're gonna go this way still. We're gonna ignore the narrator.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Where are we going to go now? It's on this little
Look,
lift.
Stanley, right. I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please.
Sylvain used to be a big fan of Office. I still need to watch the UK ones. I like the US ones.
I'm not asking for me. I'm asking for her.
All right.
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
In this room. Whoa, shit, there's like a telephone.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this.
Okay.
To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
It's all about Stanley, apparently. All right, now what?
Oh, Stanley, is that you? Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. All right. Okay, there we go. All right.
Oh, there's a French version too. I had no idea.
You're damn well.
Oh, okay. Some naked.
Gotcha. Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife who'd want to commit their life to you? I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Okay.
This is a
crazy,
very
bold,
sad
naked
story
lady
about the death of a man named Stanley.
Oh no.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence. Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do.
Hmm.
Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home.
Uh-huh.
Now he's coming back to work.
Uh-huh.
One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Hey! Guys, I've got a few problems reading the YouTube comments at the moment. Let me just fix this up. How you going, sir? It's good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Sorry, I'm just trying to fix some things here. All right, here we go. Left trigger.
But in his mind, in his mind,
good to see you, sir. Thank you for coming in.
Adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him. And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined...
Not doing much, I'm just in this stupid fucking room right now.
He stepped out from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building, had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth. The thought excited him terribly.
Press A to spend time with the boys, okay.
So, he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold. As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations.
It's just weird, isn't it?
Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable. It was such a wonderful fantasy.
Stanley is very
so
special.
Instead,
I think Stanley's
again,
had one
again,
too many nosebleeds like Ashton
over,
Kutcher in the butterfly effect, and now he's a vegetable.
End, that he might always feel
that's
this
it's official. Stanley's really
surely
Ashton
there's
Kutcher.
There's an answer down some new path. Mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time. But there is no answer. How could there possibly...
Where did my wife go?
In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has.
Hey!
Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets, the more he forgets which life is the real one. And I'm trying to tell him this, that in this world, he can never be anything but an observer, that as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
I'm going to do it anyway.
Can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
I'm going to not press a button right now. Can I not press a button? See what happens? Press Y to question nothing. I'm seeing if I can not press a button. Maybe I have to press a button. Press Y to question nothing. Can I press a different button?
I suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time he'll see. Maybe this time. And I tried again. And Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again. And Stanley
this is
pushed
so
a button.
Whack. Oh, dude, we have to do this one more time. One more time. What a freaking whack-ass mother bitch game. Seriously. I told you this was interesting, D-Wayne. What do you think? This is...
Just a step through this door, Stanley thought to himself. That's all I need.
Oh, my God.
If I can make it through this door, I can make it through them all.
Let's see what I can do now. All right, so I'm going to...
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
No, I'm going to go this way, and then I'll try and do something else.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge
first, just to
admire it.
We made this, I'm not sure, actually. We don't need to hang around in here.
Sublime, a work of art. What but eager to get back to business?
Justin with 100 stars. Thank you, Justin. I really appreciate that. So I'll go in here one more time.
Stanley was so bad at following
I'm just trying to take a different path.
He wasn't fired years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong
Let's
foot.
Let's try this one more time. How you going, JR? Good really to see you.
I realize that investing in
I'll be right with you, Justin. I'm just trying to...
But the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
There's Can I walk off this thing?
Stanley. But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. This is going out to you, Justin. Thank you so much. Oh, my God. All right, there we go. So, Suicidal Stanley. No, we're gonna do this one. Okay, begin the game again. Oh, fuck. All right. Well, let's do one more. Jeez, man.
All his coworkers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
That was awesome.
When Stanley came to a
set of two
doors...
I don't know why I find that so
doors,
funny for. How you going there, Patricia? Nice to see you. All right, we'll go this way one more time. We'll go on the elevator and then we'll obey after the, well.
Perhaps
we won't jump off
this
time.
The employee lounge first, just to admire it.
No.
Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the first but eager
so
to get
I
back
think
to
after,
business,
I think took the first after we take the elevator, we obey instructions, then we'll have something different, I think. Does his job have life insurance?
Stanley
I don't think it
so
does.
Bad at following directions. It's incredible he wasn't fired.
Oh, don't
ago.
Kill yourself this time, Stanley. Life's precious, my friend.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
So, we're going to obey the rules this time. We should be fine.
Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself.
Okay.
Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
So where do we go this time?
Stanley, your chance to redeem yourself, to put your work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Oh, is this the phone again?
That's
Can we not answer
Stanley.
The phone? I'm going to try not
you
to answer the phone.
You need to be the one to do this, to reach out to her.
I'm going to not answer the phone and see what happens.
If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Not going to pick the phone up today. Can we unplug it? Yeah, I'm not going to answer the phone. See what happens. How long do we got to let it ring out? Can we unplug it?
As Stanley picked up the phone, a white light engulfed him, filling him not just with radiance, but with hope. Hope for a life reunited one...
Okay.
Wait. Oh, goodness. Stanley, did you just unplug the phone?
I did unplug the phone.
That wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly. I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check. No, it's definitely here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone. He's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another. Music comes in, fade to white, roll credits. Not picking up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible? None of these decisions were supposed to mean anything. I don't understand. How on earth are you making meaningful choices? What did you... Wait a second. Did I just see... No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner? You're not Stanley. You're a real person. I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices. And to think I've been letting you run around in this game for so long. If you've made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely. It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making. Or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch.
I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
Choice.
Fucking
it's the
hell,
best
man.
Part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Stephen has a choice. He could spend years helping improve the quality of life for citizens of impoverished third world nations. Or he could systematically set fire to every orphan living in a 30 kilometer radius of his house. Which choice would you make? Remember that unlike here, the real world makes sense, and at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought, then provide an excuse why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice
hey,
saying,
on, Rich, good
my
to
goodness,
see you.
Is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back, sack, and crack.
Okay.
Excellent. Making choices on a regular basis is the best part to a
Dude,
healthy decision-making process.
I know.
Most medical professionals
how interesting it is, I know.
Choices per day.
I think this game
do
won some awards for just how unique
less?
It was, actually, if I'm not
and
mistaken.
Finally,
this has got a cult
following,
this game.
If you begin to wonder if your
game.
Choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant, and the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Okay.
Ah, welcome back. You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're properly informed on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
We're gonna go backwards? Okay. I'm gonna fuck around with this narrator some more. Okay. I'm gonna fuck with this guy. It's funny.
Now that we know your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying.
Oh, imagine okay, I was about to try, actually.
Dying senselessly halfway through the story. That story would make no sense at all. We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse.
This is really interesting.
It seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
All right, well, we're going to go out and yah. And where's this going to take me this time? Okay.
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending, the story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the
take
real
take the door
world.
On the left, it says.
Now remember, all you need to do is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Okay.
All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Nah, mate, fuck off.
No! Why did you do that?
Because you're an asshole.
Hurry back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Nope, we are too late, mate. We're going this way. I know better, man. What the hell's going on with that painting? Nope, we're too late. Too late, brother, too late. No, I want to go this way. Shut the door. I want to go this way. Bruh, let me go this way. Why are you forcing me to go the other way? Bruh, shut the door. Dude, is it going to force me to go the other way? Oh, I'm going to hang here another 10 seconds and see what happens. No, I think I have to go the other way. Well, that sucks. I thought I got a choice. Okay, fine. Can we go back in this door again? Yeah, I'm just... I'm just, okay, I was just double checking, that's fine, whatever. Alright, fine, we'll go this way. Now what?
It's ruined. I can't believe, after everything we talked about, that my story, you've destroyed my work! Why? For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing the game undone, left here like so much garbage? It's worthless now. And what am I supposed to do? Even if there were a way to continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How can I go back to that? I can't erase that knowledge. I'll have to live with it forever, reliving its impossibility forever. I couldn't live that way. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? I don't know. What's the answer? What do I do? What do I do?
Can we go back through the other door? I'm sorry.
No, I have to. I have to shut the game down. I have to. I have to.
Okay. What the hell's going on over Mnyaz?
I'm here. I'm still here. Here in this pile of rubbish. With you. You. Who thought you were so clever. Now look where we are.
My entire game
is destroyed. It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you've run it into the ground. What, did you think that would be funny? You just had to see?
It was funny at the time. Didn't
I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley? He actually knows how to do what I tell him to.
I think I did.
He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it. That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it? That there's a world outside of you? You're a child.
I'm a big child.
My story. If you'd just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious. It would have been so perfect. I worked so hard on it. I tried so hard. Behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay, there you go. I think that's all the Stanley parable I can handle for this evening. I have to go to bed now. This game is a total mindfuck, guys. Wow, that was interesting. We'll definitely put that on as a bonus game in the future. That was, I don't know about you guys, but I thought that was really, really interesting. Thank you for watching, guys. We did that for almost 50 minutes, actually. And thank you so much for coming into One Coin Only. I need to have a little bit of a nap now, though, guys, so I can get up early enough to do Beat It or Eat It, The Season Return. We got this, don't forget, guys. The World's Hottest Corn Chips. As punishment if I end up losing. But, yeah, we also got Dwayne on at 7. Don't forget to check him out. He's also going to be doing some Mortal Kombat DLC on Headlock Gaming today, guys. Thank you so much for coming in, guys. Thank you for the likes and the shares, all the love. I really, really appreciate you all. I'm going to cue out the outro now, and I'll send you guys to another stream. So until later today, be good, guys. Thank you for coming in.